Indonesia is planning a long-term strategy to cope with the COVID-19 pandemic, even as it fights its worst outbreak to date. Jakarta will study what other countries are doing to treat the virus as endemic. In this exclusive interview, Saiful Bahri Ismail spoke to the country's minister in charge of pandemic response, Luhut Panjaitan.
So we shall just consider, if we are able to vaccinate 100%, what are we going to do? So we can open mall, maybe with 50% or 60%, but have to be a vaccination card. That's option. Maybe every traveling, everywhere you go, you have to bring your vaccination card. And then you have to wear also, you know, masks. Like industry, maybe we can make it 3 shifts. You cannot eat together. You can bring your own food. Something like that. So there are so many things that we are exploring right now. And we see, and then we make it the roadmap of this. How do we do this?
It has been nearly a month since stricter public activity restrictions were introduced on the 3rd of July. How would you assess the effectiveness of these restrictions to curb the spread of COVID-19?
Well, I think we are quite happy so far, although it's too early to say that we are able to manage this one. But we can see the trend plateau, flattening, and then after 3 weeks, you can see decrease, but even though still have some up and down. For the next 1 or 2 weeks, going to be much better situation. Besides that, vaccination program also moving very well. This month was still around 1 million per day, but next month, we can go up to 1.5 to maybe even up to 2 million jabs every day.
COVID-19 cases have not decreased significantly. On Tuesday, more than 2,000 deaths were reported, which is the highest so far. On the ground, many COVID-19 patients who are self-isolating at home are dying because they have trouble accessing hospital care. How do you resolve this problem?
Well, number one, I think issue about how to convince this, especially elderly or with the comorbid, to when they get positive, to move to the quarantine. That's, I think, very important because the culture of them, they feel very comfortable to stay with the family. While this is also a problem because it could be, the new cluster. But the problem number of death yesterday was very painful for us. 2,000, that's, I think, we like to see this number going to be declined for the next coming weeks. We deploy right now our TNI and our police to support, to convince, to bring them peacefully to the quarantine.
President Joko Widodo has set a target of 5 million vaccinations per day. How and when do you think this can be achieved?
President asked me last night also to remind me about that target. And I believe we can do it. Well, we have to do it gradually. If this coming month we're successful to do 2 million, I think we can go by September maybe to 1.5 or so. So I'm quite confident because we have to move very fast in order to, to contain this COVID.
Indonesians are known to be very resilient people. However, do you see COVID-19 as the biggest test on solidarity that the country has ever faced?
Saiful, in my experience, this is, I think, the biggest ever in our history problem across the country. Some problem maybe like disaster, like earthquake here in just maybe one area. But this one just across the country. Yeah, but we are lucky right now we are able to, set up our strategy to control per island, per area. So like Bali vaccinated over there 85%. Soon going to be around 90%. So Bali, we don't have problem with Bali anymore because we prepare Bali for the G20. So we hope by end of this year, Bali could claim, I'm not saying zero cases, but they are going to be stable.